everyone, this is Jules with Healthies, bringing you another weekend yoga vinyasa flow. Today's class is all about feeling great in your body and in your movement. So I'm gonna let you crank it up a notch or dial it back and give yourself whatever you need from this practice today. So no need to do exactly what I'm doing, as with all of my yoga classes. So just kind of find what feels great for your body today. We're gonna start in a seated position. That does not have to be crossed legs, but I would like for you to sit nice and tall and lengthen the spine. Palms up, palms down, or hands at your heart. And we'll come into a nice even breath. In through the nose, and out through the nose. And as you start to calm your breathing down, we can lengthen out the in-breath to a count of three, and lengthen the out-breath to a count of three. And maybe tapping into the posture a little bit. Checking in with the body, scanning from head to toe. Noticing if you're holding any tension anywhere. I know a lot of times shoulders, neck, jaw, just do a little wiggle anywhere that you might be feeling some tension. Scanning down the body, down through the torso, even the hips. A lot of times hip flexors can feel some tension, so maybe just a little bit of movement. Send your breath into those areas, all the way down to your toes. And we'll slowly open the eyes. On an inhale, float the arms up overhead until your palms touch. Exhale, glide the palms down to heart center. Inhale, nice big lift out of the hips, gently engaging the abs, and we'll twist over to the right. Inhale to sit tall, and exhale just to help yourself a little deeper into your twist, not forcing anything. Be able to maintain that flow of breath. Inhale back up overhead and exhale. Just dive forward over the legs. Nice reach forward. And let your next inhale roll you back up to seated. Exhale, settle in. Inhale, big lift up overhead. Exhale, hands come down to your heart. Inhale, reach it high, lengthening both sides of the body. And exhale, little twist over to the left this time. Let's drop this front shoulder away from the ear. Imagine your collarbones gliding away from one another. And on your next inhale, big reach up. Exhale, dive forward. Let the crown of your head be really heavy, stretching all the way down the spine. Breathe into the low back. And inhale. Stack the spine, rolling up one backbone at a time, sitting nice and tall. Swing those legs around. We'll come into an all fours position. Either flattening out the feet, getting the dust off your mat. You can either flatten out the feet here, or if your ankles are not quite flexible enough for that, just tuck your toes wherever feels most comfortable. taking a few rounds of cat-cow here. Knees under hips. Spread those fingertips wide. On an inhale, release the belly. Lift the tailbone, lift the heart. Exhale, draw the belly button in and up towards the sky as we round over. Stretch into the mid-back. And again, we'll just flow between those two positions with the breath. So whether your breath is faster than mine or slower than mine, doesn't matter. Yoga is all about moving with your breath. Ear itch. It's the worst. And coming back to that flat back once you're finished that third or fourth round. So we're going to take another series of cat-cow. Feel free to come off the wrist, give them a little roll, especially if you type all day or you've been writing. I mean, we are going to spend some time on our hands today. So just gently stretching, getting a little range of motion. This next round of cat-cow, I'm going to give you the freedom to move either through circles. Maybe you want to send it back through your child's pose, or even come side to side. Take freedom, explore the space around you, explore different movement patterns with this, but always follow your breath. So we'll take about six to eight rounds here. I enjoy a little bit of lateral movement, just stretching out the obliques and the lower back. Make sure you go both directions if you're taking a circle. Maybe just 2 to 3 more rounds. Fill the lungs, empty the lungs. Now when you're ready, find that flat back. And we'll take it into an easy down dog to start tucking the toes, engaging the core, and lifting those hips nice and high up to the sky, gently dropping the heels. This is our first one, so we'll be nice and gentle with the hamstrings and the calves. Strong arms press into all 10 fingertips. Spin those elbow creases forward. Glide the shoulder blades towards your hips. And then start to walk your big toes together. Still pedaling out. Still breathing. Sink both heels, and then on an inhale, rise up on the toes. Lots of space under the heels. Exhale, sink them into your mat. And keep your knees a little bit soft, a little bit buoyant here. Inhale, lift the heels up. Exhale, lower back down. And one more time, big lift. Exhale, sink and lengthen the backs of the legs. On your next inhale, we'll lift the hips high to shift forward into a nice long plank. Opening up the collarbones here. And just taking a few breaths here. Your plank might be down on your knees, and that's totally okay. Just drop those hips. We're exploring space today, so what does that negative space look like underneath of you? What does that space feel like between your shoulders and your ears? Take one more breath in. On your exhale, lower the knees and come all the way down onto your belly. Roll the shoulders back and inhale, little cobra. Lengthening both the front and back body here. exhale, we return back down. And we'll do that two more times. Inhale, reach forward to come up. Exhale, lengthen the spine. Last one, press into those palms. Keep the back of the neck long. And then press back into a child's pose, sinking hips to heels, inching the fingertips forward. Let's keep those arms active and alive here. Elbow creases, spin up towards the sky. A deep breath into the low back. A full exhale, maybe a sigh. And one more time, big inhale. And a big sigh. Coming back up to a downward dog. Push into the hands, really connect with your foundation to lift up. Big toes together, heels are slightly apart. Inhale, look forward to your thumbs. Step, take a little walk. Maybe you're ready to jump. I'm gonna walk a bit and just hang over the legs here. Take hands to elbows. Do a gentle sway, maybe a gentle bounce. I like to do a little head shake, yes and no. To completely release the neck. And this time you can let gravity just melt your shoulders towards the floor. One more full round of breath. Release the arms. And we'll roll up nice and slow, tucking the tailbone, engaging the abdominals to articulate one backbone at a time. Nice, luscious, slow roll up. And your head is the last thing to come up. Big shoulder roll here at the top. And exhale, finding mountain pose. Fingertips are sending energy out into the floor. Crown of the head is reaching. Energy up to the sky. Come back to that three count breath. In through the nose, out through the nose. On your next inhale, lift it up high. Catch a hold of one wrist, and we're just going to turn and face you so you can see. And we're lifting way up out of the hips, reaching over. I'm going to the right, so I'm sending my hips to the left. Drawing the lower abs in and up to lengthen the low back. And I'm squeezing the glutes, hips are pressing forward. So lots of work here, even as we stretch. On an inhale, engage the obliques to come back up to center. And we'll go the opposite direction. Exhale, catch that wrist. Hips press towards the side gently. Just remind that top shoulder to relax a little. And we're not tipping forward. Inhale, back up to center. This time we'll take palms together overhead, squeeze those hips forward, lift and mini back bend if that's in your practice. If not, you can just reach as high as possible. One more breath in, and on your exhale, take it into a slow forward fold. Tailbone reaches back, heart shines forward, all the way over the legs. Inhale. Lengthening halfway up, take a shoulder roll here. So we're supporting from underneath here, drawing the belly button in. Lengthening the back of the neck. And we're just going to let the arms go here, little circles. Let gravity kind of pull the arm gently away from the socket, creating a little space. This is a really nice exercise if you have any tightness or pinching going on in your shoulders day to day. This helps to kind of release some pressure. On your next Next exhale, folding forward, stepping back into a plank. Pressing through those heels. And just do a little shift forward and back. Explore that plank position a little bit. Inhale, shift forward. Exhale, take a slow chaturanga. You can come to knees here if you need. Elbows hug in. And you can repeat the cobra that we did. Or if you're ready, press into up dog. Maybe do a little head turn side to side here. Keep pressing into the tops of the feet, into the palms. Drawing the belly button in, squeezing those glutes. That'll help protect the low back. Exhale, belly button pulls in, downward facing dog. Relax the head here, relax the neck. And let's see if we can just shift the chest through the arms a bit more this time. So it should feel like your chest is reaching for your thighs. On your next inhale, we'll lift the right heel way up behind us. Keep those toes pointing to the floor. A full exhale here. Inhale, lift the heel higher. And exhale, turn your hips to the right as we bend the knee. Stretching out that hip flexor. Watch those shoulders are gonna wanna turn. Keep them facing your mat. Stretching out that right hip flexor. Lifting the thigh and pressing it back. One more inhale. One more exhale. Inhale, return back to your three-legged dog. Big lift. And exhale, we'll step it forward and come into a nice low lunge. So we're dropping the back knee, untucking the toes. Lengthen, spine first. And then on an inhale, press into your foundation. We'll come up to a low crescent lunge. Gliding shoulders down back, drawing pinkies back behind us. And on an exhale, bring it on down. Tuck those toes, press into your low runner's lunge here. And just wiggle however you need to, and we'll come through a vinyasa, your version. So a slow chaturanga, cobra or up dog. Any version of down dog that feels good for you. It's okay to keep your knees bent here. Lots of intention in our movement today. We're kind of slowing it down, giving our bodies and our brains time to register each movement. One more exhale. Inhale, the left heel floats high. Exhale, stay here. Inhale, lift a little more, and exhale, hips turn to the left this time, bending the knee. And if you can peek under that armpit, just shift those shoulders back to center. So we're rotating from the waist down. Lift the knee high, press it on back. And on an inhale, returning back to three-legged dog, big lift. Exhale, step it through. How much space can you create underneath of yourself as we step through? Finding a low lunge. Space in the neck and shoulders. And when you're ready, a gentle lift. Left hip crease is sliding back as the right hip gently presses forward. One more inhale. Exhale, bring it on down. Tuck the toes. And just step forward into your forward fold. On an inhale, come halfway up. On your exhale, release. Inhale, rise through flat back this time. And exhale, hands back to heart center. Shake it out, readjust if you need to. And then join me when you're ready. Inhale, big reach up. Catch a wrist, lift up and over, hips press to the side. Inhale to center, a little faster this time. Exhale, tipping side. Inhale, big reach up overhead. Exhale, squeeze the glutes together as we lift and reach back. Inhale, lift it up. And exhale, forward fold over the legs. Inhale, come into a chair pose, sinking hips low. Toes together, knees together. Give a nice squeeze in and sink low. You should be able to wiggle the toes here. One more breath in. Exhale, forward fold. Step back into your plank and flow through your version of vinyasa. I'm going to invite you to build a little strength here. Maybe you want to add a little push-up here, a little chaturanga push-up. Your choice. And always feel free to come to child's pose for a moment if you need. Sinking, heels low. Relaxing the neck. Inhale the right heel way up. Exhale, big step forward, coming into a high crescent lunge this time. However you need to get there. Right hip peels back. Inhale, big lift up. Take one more breath in your crescent. On your exhale, press arms back to airplane. Nice little angled lunge here. So we're lifting abs away from the front thigh, drawing the right hip crease back, pressing through the back heel, and arms are pressing for the sky. Exhale, bring it on down. Vinyasa flow. Maybe add that push up. On an inhale, we lift the left heel. Exhale, step it on forward, finding high crescent on the left side. So just take this left hip crease, slide it on back, dig into your front heel. Sink into your back heel as well. One more breath in, lengthen. Exhale, engage the core, engage the arms, coming into that angle with airplane arms. Energy through the crown of the head. Maybe sink a little lower. One more inhale. And exhale, just step it on forward. Come back to your nice neutral forward fold. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, release. And inhale, big lift up overhead. Exhale, hands to heart center. And take as many breaths in here as you need. Feel free to pause the video. Or you can flow right along with me. Inhale, big reach up. Exhale, same thing. Tipping to the side, maybe finding extra length here. Inhale to lift up, exhale to reach over. Are those inner thighs squeezing together? Exhale, squeeze them and press forward. Lots of length here in the spine. Inhale, lift up. And exhale, forward fold.
Inhale halfway up.
Exhale, release.
Coming back to chair pose on an inhale.
Hands come to heart center in prayer. Press palm into palm. Twist to the right. Left elbow to the outside of the right thigh.
And then pressing the palms to lift heart to thumbs.
Glide the left hip back so the knees are aligned.
And try to find length in the spine.
Inhale back to center. And exhale, we twist the other way.
Elbow to thigh.
Pressing, twisting, lengthening. Check in, are you still sinking low? Inhale, come back to center. And exhale, step it back, flow through.
Feel free to come down to child's pose for a few breaths, or if you're okay resting here in down dog, just check in, maybe do another head to toe body scan, touch base with the breath. Sometimes when we're working really hard, we kind of lose that steady flow of breath.
And when you're ready, we'll inhale the right heel high. Exhale, big step forward.
I'm gonna find a warrior two.
So big spiral with the arms, windmilling up to warrior two. Front knee is aligned with the middle toe. Back foot turns out 90 degrees. And our arms are just radiating energy from our center. Gently look over the front hand. We'll find a peaceful warrior, flip the front palm, reach it forward, up, and a little bit back as the back arm glides to that back heel. Drop that shoulder when it was starting to creep up. And exhale back to warrior two. Inhale, press through the front knee, big reach up overhead. Palms touch, exhale, press the arms down. Inhale, reach forward, coming into side angle. A little modified side angle here. Try not to collapse on this arm. On an inhale, come back to your warrior two. Exhale, press the leg straight. Inhale, lift up. And exhale, come back down into warrior two. Maybe a little deeper bend here. And then straighten legs and turn this front leg so that it's parallel with the back. So we're in a nice wide stance here. And then just scoot both heels in a little bit. So a big wide, almost like a sumo squat position. For Skandasana, I'm gonna show you two versions. One is a little bit more stretchy. The other is gonna build a bit more strength. So sinking down towards that front leg, keeping the back leg straight. And just tap the fingertips to the floor, come up onto the heel in the back, and try to keep the front heel down. So you might need to adjust the width of your legs here. So this is a really intense inner thigh stretch, and we're just going to easily flow back and forth side to side. Your straight leg will rotate to the sky, knees up, toes up. So just flowing with the breath. So hang out there if that's feeling awesome for you today. If you want to build a little more strength, we're going to use the legs here, hands at heart center, and press into that front leg to shift sides, staying low and sinking, keeping a nice long spine. And maybe just do one more shift back. And one more shift forward. Let's all come back up into our warrior two for one breath in. One big exhale. Straighten through that front leg. And we'll tip into a triangle pose. So reaching forward, sending the hips back, hand to shin, ankle, or floor. Just a few breaths here. On an exhale, gently release the top arm. And make your way through a vinyasa, optional child's pose. I think I forgot the push-up last time. Coming back to the breath. We'll inhale the left heel high. Exhale, step it through. And turning out, coming into warrior two. On the other side, checking in with alignment. We'll take two more deep breaths. Inhale straight through the front leg, big reach up. Palms touch, exhale your way back down. Inhale forward, up and back, peaceful warrior. Exhale, warrior two. On an inhale, we reach up. On an exhale, we return. Side angle pose. Inhale, reach forward. Exhale. If you want to take this one all the way down, please be my guest. I think I'm going to hang out in a modified one today. Inhale your way back up to warrior two. This time, exhale, straighten the leg. And inhale back down. Straighten the leg, turn the toes parallel, scoot the heels. So we're taking, I'm gonna turn and face you, but stay where you are. We're taking Skandasana again, on the other side, sinking towards that front leg first, enjoying that stretch, side to side. So I worked on the first side, I'm gonna stretch on the second side. Again, if you want that little burn, you're coming hands to your heart. Just be careful of range of motion here. It's okay to stay high. One more time to the front and back. I'm gonna flip back around some on the right side, but maybe do one more round. And when you're ready, come back up to your warrior two. One breath in, one breath out. Straighten through that front leg. And we'll stretch it out in our triangle pose, reaching forward, tipping over to the side. And opening up the chest to the sky. Exhale that top arm back down, turn forward, and step forward, and just finding a nice neutral forward fold. Take a hold of elbows, lick gravity, draw length into the neck. Fill up the low back with breath. Exhale all the air out. Let the arms go. Come down onto all fours. So we're going to take it down a notch. Maybe do a little wiggle side to side. Bring toes together, knees to the outer edges of your mat, and send the hips back for child's pose. Take
3 more rounds of breath here. Slowly walk your hands back towards your knees as we roll and round up. One backbone at a time. Roll the shoulders at the top. So we're going to wind it down a little bit. Come to a seated position with your legs out towards each side. And if this is like an absolutely not thing for you, just bring the legs in a little bit. I know this can be a very stretchy position for most people, especially inner hips, hip flexors. If you have a pillow or a block you want to sit up on, sometimes that really helps take any of the work out of the hip flexors, and it'll be much more beneficial to the legs and low back. So whatever is a comfortable wide leg stance for you. Mine's about 45 degrees. Fingertips are planted behind you. I'm just kind of like up on my fingertips. Take a nice big inhale, lengthen the spine, and then hinge forward just till you feel that stretch on the inner thigh. Right, so the goal is not head to the floor. The goal is to just stretch out the hips. One more breath in, and then we'll sit tall. Tuck the right leg in, sole of the right foot to the thigh of the left, and then just turn and face that left leg. Take a nice big inhale, exhale, reach forward. You do not have to touch your toes. You can do hands to shin, wherever. Just add a little weight, a little press down with this leg. There's a little work going on in the right leg. Release and sit tall. Take your right hand, or whatever leg is bent, that's the hand that you're going to take way behind you, kind of out to the angle. Press into your palm, the shin of your bent leg, and your foot of the straight leg. And we're taking the hips nice and high, releasing the hip flexors, fingertips to the sky. And exhale, carefully come back down. Send your leg out straight, bend the other leg in. We'll stretch to the other side. Sitting nice and tall. Release any tension. Inhale, turn and face that right leg, or whatever leg is straight, and reach it out first before you go down. We want length in our stretch. And really use that exhale to kind of twist you more parallel with your straight leg. Breath out, and then walk yourself back up to a tall seated position. Left hand this time, reaching about a foot, foot and a half behind your hip, pressing into your foundation as we lift high, releasing the hip flexors. And slowly on an exhale, releasing the hips back down, turning to face the front of our mat. Really winding down now, roll it down onto your back, try to massage the spine, one backbone at a time. Just release your arms open as we windshield wipe our side to side. Pausing center. Send your right toes to the sky, then cross your knee way over your thigh. I'm really crossing my legs, and keep dropping both legs over towards the left. My right leg is like tucked under the left. And then I'm just shifting my shoulders so they're flat on the floor. I'm in a really big spiral right now. You can lengthen out the breath. My left hand is kind of just gently helping me into this twist. Very slowly release that twisted leg, come back to center. Recenter yourself, maybe do a windshield wiper. Send the left toes high, cross it way over. And then drop legs to the right. Open up that left side. Use the exhale to deepen the twist. One more full round of breath. Slowly unwinding. Coming back to center, rock your head side to side. Draw the knees in, give them a big hug. The final stretch of the day is just a nice hip release. Lengthen the tailbone. If you like to take happy baby, hands to the outer edges of your feet, and you can rock and roll side to side. I kind of like just a little knee hug here. And slowly make your way into Shavasana by sending the legs long, allowing the arms to drape open, glide the shoulders under you. Breathe some relaxation into the neck, into the jaw, into the eyes and forehead. And letting your breath become shallow. Let your muscles melt into the earth. If you know you'd like to take a longer Shavasana today, go ahead and pause the video and just stay here for as long as you'd like until you're ready to start your day. And if you're ready to seal in your practice, we'll invite some small movements back into the body, hands, feet, ankles, wrists. A gentle rock side to side with the head. Opening the eyes. Gently folding over to one side. Pause here if you'd like, or press up to a comfortable seat. Seal in our practice just with a little gratitude for yourself for making it onto your mat today, showing yourself a little self-love, self-care. Definitely gratitude towards those around us in our lives who have just been helping this time become a little bit easier. I know I have wonderful people in my life who are just making this time much more enjoyable. And thank you guys so much for joining me today. Again, for yoga on your weekend, let's bring thumbs to third eye center. Bow forward. Namaste.